by the inverse transform of s squared plus 6s plus 9 all over s minus 1 times s minus 2 times s plus 4. First of all, first looking at this, we cannot find the inverse transform of a product. And by looking at the table which I have here, there's nothing that matches the one of the form I have here. So for this one, we need to rewrite this in form of a addition or subtraction. Let me rewrite and work on this specifically. S squared plus 6, S plus 9, over S minus 1, S minus 2, S plus 4. So to rewrite this in a fraction form of single term here, we need to use a partial fraction decomposition. So I'm going to have, let's call a variable A over S minus 1, which is the first factor, plus B over S minus 2, plus C over S plus 4. Okay, so if you combine all these, you will multiply this by this, this by this and this, and multiply this by this and this. We don't know A, B, C, but it will form this one, and our goal is to find A, B, and C. So I'm going to multiply both sides by S minus 1 times S minus 2 times S plus 4. Then on the left side, I have S plus 6, S plus 9 is equal to A times S minus 2 times S plus 4 plus B times S minus 1 times S plus 4 plus C times S minus 1 times S minus 2. Now, we have to find A, B, and C. So you can multiply this out, but it's wise to not do that because when I look at these, I'm gonna ask myself then, is there a way that I can wipe out one of these? So if I let s equal 2, it wipes out this one and this one, right? But we cannot let s equal 2 because we have it on the denominator. That's why the calculus comes into play. I can let s equal 2, but I can let s approach 2. So let's do it for 1 first. Let s approach 1. So on the left side, I have 1 squared plus 6 times 1, which is 7, plus 9 is 16. Equal, let s approach 1 on the right side. So I have 1 minus 2, which is negative 1, negative 5a. 1 minus 1, 0, 0. So I get a equals negative 16 over 5 right away. Now I'm going to do the same thing. Let s approach 2. Then on the left side, I have 2 squared, which is 4, plus 12, 16, 25. On the right side, this is gone. So 2 minus 1, 2, 6, 12. 2 minus 1 is 1. 2, 6, 6, 1, 60. Then I have B equals 25 over 6. Now, do the same thing. Let S approach negative 4. On the left side, we have negative 4 squared, 16. 16 plus 9, 25, negative, positive 25 minus 24, which gives me 1. So negative 4, negative 4, this is gone. Negative 4, negative 1, negative 5, negative 6, 30, C. So I get C equals 1 over 30. Now I'm going to plug A, B, and C into this one. So up here, I have the L inverse of negative 16 over 5. Times 1 over s minus 1 plus 25 over 6 times 1 over s minus 2 plus c, and c is 1 over 30 times 1 over s plus 4. Okay, so this is the L inverse of this. Now for this one, I'm gonna apply the L inverse into every single term inside. Then for this one, I'm gonna pull out the negative 16 over 5. So L inverse of this is equal to e to the t. This one plus 25 over 6, L inverse of this is going to be e to the 2t plus 1 over 30. And L inverse of this is equal to e to the negative 4t. So we have the formula that says the Laplace transform of e to the at equals 1 over s minus a. So L inverse of this will get you back to this one, which is what I have here, okay? So this is your final answer. Let me box it here. Okay, so this is your final answer. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.